At first, energy harvesting sounds like a topic related to free energy, which is a subject flooded with fake designs of machines that create more power on the output than they require on the input, which makes them perpetual motion machines. But of course, there does not exist such a machine, which is why I even exposed two designs of such fake machines in my free energy BS video. But what is energy harvesting then, you might ask? Well, let's imagine we got an IoT system, which for example consists of a microcontroller and a sensor. The microcontroller's job is to power up every hour, get the sensor's current measurement, which can be for example the temperature, send this data out to a receiver and then go into deep sleep. Let's imagine this system needs 3.3 volts and draws 10 milliamps for 1 second while gathering the data and sending it out, but otherwise the system only draws 3 microamps in deep sleep. That means such a common LiPo battery with a capacity of 7.4 watt hours could theoretically power the IoT system for around 44 years. Which sounds good at first. But have fun replacing perhaps thousands of those batteries all around your factory after practically speaking 10 years. And maybe half or more of those batteries will probably be dead and cannot be reused. So wouldn't it be awesome to just harvest energy from nearby available energy sources like the sunlight, mechanical vibrations, heat or radio frequencies and power our IoT systems with that? And I know this sounds a bit crazy, but it is partly easily possible. And I will test it out in this video to find out whether energy harvesting makes any sense at all. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by JLC PCB. Feel free to visit their website jlcpcb.com to not only find out what awesome PCB and assembly services they offer, but also to easily upload your Gerber files and thus order affordable and high quality PCBs quickly. First off, I have to say that using sunlight to power electronics is certainly not crazy nowadays, and widely known as a photovoltaic system. I even made several videos about the topic, like building a photovoltaic off-grid system in my garage or creating my own solar panel. And that is why I will not talk much further about this topic in this video. But let me just say that you can get such a small solar panel for relatively cheap, and they can easily output more than enough power for our imaginary IoT circuits. With that out of the way, let's move on to mechanical vibrations, which you can commonly find in factories due to motors. And a good example for that in your households is your washing machine, which I will be using as a test subject in a second. Before doing that though, we have to think about what makes up an energy harvesting system. At the beginning, we obviously need a harvester, which turns our source energy into raw electrical energy. Then we need a conversion circuit that takes our raw electrical energy, which was maybe an AC voltage, and turns it into a DC voltage, which we can then use to charge up the next part of the system, the energy storage. This can be a normal or supercapacitor with enough capacity to power the last part of the system, the electronic load. And now that we are familiar with the basic structure, let's try to come up with a complete system for the mechanical vibration energy. As a harvester, we can use such a piezoelectric disc, which after soldering wires to its two plates, outputs an AC waveform whenever we hit it. But as you can see, such a tiny disc cannot really output big voltage spikes, which we will definitely need. That is why I got myself a bigger disc, which can certainly output higher voltages. Next, we need a conversion circuit, which turns the AC voltage into a DC voltage. And for that, we need such a full bridge rectifier circuit, which I created with the help of four 1N5822 Schottky diodes. Those diodes are suitable for this job since they feature a low forward voltage and they also work with high frequencies. So, after hooking up the rectifier to the disc, all we have to figure out was a suitable capacitor value, for which I firstly chose a 22 microfarad one as a test. After hooking that up to the rectifier's output and then connecting my oscilloscope probes to it, I hit the disc with the handle of one of my screwdrivers continuously. And as you can see, the voltage went up to a value of 5 volts within just 7 seconds. The gathered energy was even sufficient to power a 5mm red LED for a brief moment. Which is why I wanted to push this system even further by hooking up a 220 microfarad capacitor. As you can see, the voltage took quite a bit longer to increase up to 5 volts. But this time we can let the LED light up longer. And even a tiny bit continuously, which was a very good sign. So, as a final test, I used double-sided tape to attach the disc to my washing machine, selected the spin option and hit start. As you can see on the oscilloscope, the voltage climbed super slowly and never reached values to illuminate the LED. By switching to a smaller capacitor value, the rise time did decrease quite a bit, but hitting the disc was certainly more effective. But nevertheless, even though the last test was not perfect, I strongly believe that mechanical vibrations could power our IoT system. And with that being said, let's move on to heat, for which we can use a Peltier module as a harvester. When we heat up one side of it while keeping the other cool, the module will output a DC voltage, which we can hopefully use. The real-life example in a factory would simply be an oven or something similar. And a good example for excess heat at home would be my induction cooking field right after I'm done preparing my meal. With a temperature of around 80 degrees Celsius, it should be able to deliver a bit of energy. Which is why I simply placed the Peltier module on it, onto which I then positioned a pot for cooling the other side. Sadly though, the module only outputs around 1 volt, which was not enough for my red LED. But by simply connecting two Peltier modules in series, we can easily reach a high enough voltage and also draw enough power to light up the LED without a problem. Which is why I think that using heat as an energy source for an IoT system is definitely possible. But if you do not believe me yet, then feel free to watch my video about creating a thermoelectric generator. And that brings us to the last energy source, radio frequencies, which was the energy source I was most skeptical of. I mean, yes, according to this picture of the United States frequency allocations, there seems to be lots of radio frequencies around us, so there should be some that we can use. But the problem is that you need a specifically designed antenna for a certain frequency band. And your rectifier also needs to be able to work with such high frequencies. And let's not forget that you need to live near a radio frequency broadcaster to get any useful power. So, no matter which RF energy harvester circuit from Google Images you try out, you will most likely never get any decent results. Which is why I can say that RF energy harvesting will with high probability not power our IoT system. But nevertheless, in the end we can say that having 3 or 4 energy harvesting options to work out in a positive way is definitely not a bad result. And nowadays there even exist energy harvesting ICs. Like this UB20M1 I received from the University of Bristol. By hooking up an IR photodiode to its input and connecting an LED and power source to its output, we can see that by using a TV remote, the IC switches its output on and off according to the infrared light sent out by the TV remote. The reason is that the IC is actually powered by the energy of the infrared light and turns on its outputs as soon as a threshold voltage value on the input is reached. That means instead of leaving your TV in standby mode, in which the TV still draws a small amount of power, we could use such an IC in order to decrease the TV's standby power even further and thus saving energy. And I hope that with this final example, you now understand that energy harvesting is a real electronics topic nowadays, and very important for certain applications. I hope you enjoyed this video. If so, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!